I think we should just, you know, go on with the next song, which is song number
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
For him learning. Song number 8, Die Rossen with Sunday as a Nu, which means something like as near as now, yeah, whatever. And the song is very musical-ish. Die Rossen, I like Die Rossen, actually. He has a very strong voice, but somehow and sometimes it just seems as he is not very much in touch with his feelings or something like that, you know? He seems quite cold and stern sometimes. It's quite, I don't know what it is, but, you know, he didn't sing as well in the final as he did in the semi-final. But it's still a quite strong performance, and I think this one proves that, you know, the ballads can still be strong in the Danish national finals. So, yeah, that's what I think about it. Now, I think it's time we get on to song number 9. Woohoo! I will let you never let you go. It's called Say You Love Me. It's quite a strong tune. It's a really catchy tune also. It's quite Motown-ish, and I do like it. His performances from the semi-final and the final are quite similar. Actually, there's absolutely nothing different, I guess. I don't know. There's not a lot to say about this performance. It's quite good. The only thing wrong about it is the thing he's wearing, the suit, the white suit. I think it's a bit too, I don't know, he needs to be a bit more loose, you know? So, that's what I think about it. Good performance. Now it's time for the last song, and it's number 10. In between reality and fantasy, I will make you see. Okay, that was song number 10, and the singer was DQ, who's really called Peter Andersen, and the song was Drama Queen. It was awesome, wasn't it? I like it. his performance is just brilliant, I guess. It was a bit different from the semi-final one because of his way to perform, I guess. He was way more enthusiastic in the final. He was, I think that's it. The tune is really cool. It's catchy. You can sing along with it after a few listens. And I think that's a strong thing. He might not be the best singer, but just the way the whole show was created and the tune itself, I think it's a winner. So, yeah, that's it. Now, that was all the songs. Now it's time to reveal what actually happened. What happened was, in finals, there was a pretty close race between two songs. The songs were James Samson, Say You Love Me, and DQ with Drama Queen. It all started out with one of the very, I guess, somebody's gonna kill me for saying this, the very farmer part of the country, giving Drama Queen top points, which is 12 in Denmark, as it also is in the Eurovision. That was quite unbelievable, but believe it or not, that's what happened. And then James Samson caught up with Drama Queen a few times as we got through the parts of the countries, through the regions. But in the end, we had Copenhagen. Drama Queen was ahead of with 2 points, so if James Samson got to the 12 points, he would have won. But that's not what happened. Drama Queen won, and it was great. So, what do I think made Drama Queen win? Well, it did surprise me a lot. As you saw in my video ahead of the final, I did only put Drama Queen on 3rd place, or 4th place even, because I didn't think Denmark was ready for Drama Queen and Drag Queen, as I put it. But she did win. He did win, and we'll see him in Helsinki. This is the final performance of him. See you later. Thanks for watching. That, ladies and gentlemen, that leads.